Hi, I'm Dan with DJ2 Motorsports. In this video, we're going to talk about how camber affects your tire temperatures. Hey, welcome back to the videos. Okay, in this video, we're going to talk about how the temperatures can show you how your camber is set up on your front tires. Now, just for a quick review, we need to remember that negative camber is anything past 0 degrees up and down. Negative camber is toward the center line of the car, so we're going to have the top of the tires in. And if it's a positive camber, it is out from that 0 degree from the center line. So if you're having a road, or if you're setting up a road course car, both of your front tires are probably going to have 1 or 2 degrees negative camber. So top of the tires are going to be set up, the initial camber will be set up toward the center line about 1 or 2 degrees. If you're running a circle track car, your outside front tire is probably going to have a negative camber, maybe 2, 3, 4 degrees, and your inside tire is going to have a positive camber of probably 1 or 2 degrees. Depending on your setup and your situation. And that's because as you're going through the corner, that outside tire is going to probably lay a little bit flat as you're going through the corner. So what you're trying to do, again, is get that level surface through the corner. Now, the easiest way to remember this is if the outside of your tires are running too hot, then you need to bring the top of the tire in on your initial camber setup toward the center line of the car. So you need, if it's too hot on the outside, you need to bring the top in. If it's too hot on the inside, you need to bring the top of the tire out. That's just on your initial camber settings. So you need to really pay attention to your temperatures when you're coming off the track, and hopefully that'll help you get your car set up again. So again, if your outside of your tire is too hot, you need to bring that in toward the center line of the car. If the inside is too hot, you need to push it out just a little bit, and that's only on your initial camber setting, and then you need to keep track of that throughout your testing or your racing. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. Make sure you join us on Facebook and keep up with us on Twitter. That way it'll be the best way to keep up on when we're releasing new videos. And also you can find the links at the top of our YouTube channel here. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you inside the next video.